Okay, so over the last 2 months, I have literally talked about the potential Black Ops 2 remaster, and then we went to the point where it didn't look like it was going to happen, and then the potential Black Ops 2 backwards compatibility, and then we got the news that that didn't look like it was going to happen. And what is crazy is Black Ops 2 is one of the most discussed topics in January of 2017. What's up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome back. And we're going to take one more stab at this because I have a theory. Well, it's not just my theory. There's other people that are thinking the same thing, but I want to give hope and instill hope where I think there is the possibility for hope. And now, okay, if you had the choice, you would obviously want Black Ops 2 remastered over backwards compatibility. But then again, people want, they want things now. That's the day and age we are in. People want it now. So if they were given the choice and said, well, we're not going to give you remastered, but we'll give you backwards compatibility right now, there would be some people that took the bait and they would jump on it just so they could play Black Ops 2 backwards compatible on their Xbox One. Now, I'm going to give you guys a theory on why maybe the two are actually linked together, okay? So at this point, let's recap really quick. People started talking about Black Ops 2 Remastered, and I made some videos on it as well, said, yeah, it would be awesome, but it seems like it's too far down the lifespan. It's a newer title compared to some of the older titles they've been remastered. It just doesn't seem possible. Then we started talking about backwards compatibility, and then we kind of got punched in the face by Major Nelson the other day when he was tweeting with a fan saying, no, there is nothing right now, absolutely not. Basically put him in his place and said, there are no rumors, there are no leaks, because there is nothing right now that is relevant to Black Ops 2 being backwards compatible. And then we kind of learned, or I learned at least, you may have already known, that it's not really up to Xbox. I was under the assumption that it was kind of Xbox's thing, but it's not. It's the developers, it's the publishers, it's Activision that decides to press the issue to put a game in and put it through to get it to be backwards compatible. With that information, I have a new theory. And my theory is, there is a possibility we aren't getting Black Ops 2 backwards compatible. I mean, let's think about it. From a fan standpoint, a community standpoint, it was the number one voted title to be backwards compatible. Everybody wants it backwards compatible. Why not do it? There are no negatives to it, right? Well, if Activision is the one that decides to push it through to go to Xbox One, maybe they're holding out because there is going to be a Black Ops 2 remastered. That would be the only reason I could see that they don't put it through for the fans to play, other than building up the hype. But once you start building up hype and you build it up for months and months and months, people start to get mad. Okay, it's not hype anymore, excitement, it's resentment, and it's people that are very impatient. So why would they not take the steps to get Black Ops 2 backwards compatible? It's not that big a deal, right? It's literally the same game, it just, you can access it on your Xbox One dashboard and play. Okay, why would they not do that? Especially after the community has spoken and said, this is the title we want, and they've already done other titles. Well, conspiracy theorists like myself like to think that they are holding out because maybe they are going to hit us with a bombshell, and Black Ops 2 Remastered is the next title. Now, that goes against everything that I said in the last video talking about it, because I said that makes no sense. And if we were to see Black Ops 2 Remastered, it would be 5 years down the road because it's a newer title. Why would they skip Black Ops, which would be an amazing remaster? Why would they not do World at War? Why would they not work their way through? I mean, if you look at Infinity Ward and Raven, they're starting with the original Modern Warfare title and probably would make sense to work their way through to Modern Warfare 2 and on down the line. So you would assume that Treyarch or Activision, whoever, would do the same, but maybe that is not the case. Maybe they are just going to go balls out and go for broke in 2017. Sledgehammer hits us with a Vietnam or World War title with boots on the ground. We get that old school Call of Duty grit with no advanced movement, and then they hit you with the haymaker, and they hit you with a Black Ops 2 remaster. Could you imagine the sales on that? Now, I also made a video stating I don't think it's smart to bundle a remastered with a new Call of Duty anymore. That's my opinion personally, and I don't think it is. But If they brought COD 2017 bundled with Black Ops 2 Remastered, they would probably break sales records. If they come through with the Call of Duty that everybody's expecting for COD 2017, and if they didn't do that, and they did COD 2017 and let everybody know that Black Ops 2 Remastered would come in the summer, it would still be one hell of a year for COD. But I go back, I revert back to, if it was a bundle for an old school type COD and Black Ops 2 Remastered, there's no way they don't shatter sales records. And in the end, Activision is about shattering sales records and making more money. So I'm just putting it out there. Maybe they're holding off on backwards compatibility because they don't want you to get a taste of anything, and they want you to be fully ready because they're going to hand it to you on a platter in the form of Black Ops 2 Remastered. I know it's reaching, but it's a hell of a theory. You guys let me know what you think in the comment section. Drop a like if you think that would be cool if it actually happened, and I'll see you guys later.